Yep. Okay. Hello, everyone. I would like to talk about tools CPPINCLUDE that help to analyze includes in C++. I think everyone has a situation when you change some header and wait when half a project will be compiled for a long time. Why does it happen? Because headers that include by CPP files include other header, and other headers include other headers and extra. And when file that are top of includes tree is changed, all file will be recompiled. How to avoid it? Fix from includes, use forward declaration, split big header, use pointer to implementation. One of the tools that helps to avoid it is include what you see, what you use. It's CLANG-based tool, and it's a very powerful tool that creates warning if you forget to add forward declaration or included wrong header. Also, it can fix your includes. Let's see how it works on a Hello World example. We see the tool create warning that vector should be removed. It shows situation about header how should be, and it work only with CMake. That's why sometimes it's difficult to set it for a project and don't use CMake. Other tool is CPPINCLUDE. It's very simple tool. It shows situation about header as is, and it can be used independently on build system. Let's see simple example. We have enum, base class, and two inherited classes. It's enum, it's base class that includes the enum, it's first class that includes the base class, and second class that includes the base class too. There we have abstract factory and two inherited factories for each object. It's abstract factory that includes the basic object, factory for first class that includes the abstract factory and first class, and factory for second class that includes abstract factory and second class, and main file that includes both factories. So we have enum that is included by base class that has two inherited classes, and the base class is included by abstract factory that has two inherited classes too. If we apply forward declaration for enum in base char file and for base class in base factory, we will see the file with enum will be included only by p files instead by headers. So if file with enum will be changes, only three files will be recompiled with forward declaration, instead recompiling all file without forward declaration. So tools CPPINCLUDE help to detect files that impact on a lot of files. You can see the file with enum impact to 11 files because it's included base char file that impact on inherited classes and base factory. If we run the tools on same example with forward declaration, we will see that most impact file now is best char and impact only inherited classes and main file. So with it, tools we identify which includes should be fixed in first place. Now let's see result on other projects. It's output for WLCM project. It's a very popular media player. And there some file impact about 1,500 files. It's output for big project like GDC, and there some files impacts on 10 and 6,000 files. Tools CPPINCLUDE don't depend on build system, that's why some files can be unresolved. You need add included path via arguments of in configuration file and set other parameters. Let's see how look customization in configuration file. It's JSON file There you can set includes directories and what directories of files should be ignored. The tools show includes files that are not found in the project, files that most impact on other files, unincluded headers, and headers that are included in different way with double quotation marks and uncle brackets. One moment, yeah, sorry. So let's see a simple example on VLSM. One moment. Yeah, so let's clone repository project notepad++. One moment, I copy paste repository. Okay, then cd, then open project directory. Yes, and let's try to find unresolved files. So we see a lot of files. Let's minimize number of files. And let's minimize details. Now it's look better. So let's try to find where located first file. Just find. Yeah, we found that we should add this directory to include path. Yeah, and we see that first file now is not resolved. And adding includes directories via arguments is not convenient way. That's why we can add this file in configuration file. It's very simple, just create. And let's add all directories that we should add. I have already prepared example. One moment. Yeah, now we added all directories and let's check if we have unresolved files. Yeah, now we see that we have only system unresolved files. Why it's unresolved? Because it's located in system directories and we can add these files to ignore. It's pretty simple, just type ignore files and Windows. Okay, now we see that window.h we don't have in unresolved files, and let's add odd files in ignore that we don't have in our project. Just edit our configuration file and I will copy from prepared example. Ah, I forget one option. If we open where file located, how file is included. For example, if we open this file in our editor, yeah, and we see that almost file is included by angle brackets. It's usually system includes that we shouldn't pay attention to it, and we can easily just add to ignore on includes that use angle brackets. Just add ignore system includes. Yeah, now we have few unresolved files, and it's these files also system, and we can add this file to ignore in our configuration file. Yeah, I have already prepared. Okay, and let's check. Ah, and also we can add ignore system includes in our configuration file. We can just add here. And I'll check list unresolved files. Yeah, we don't have any unresolved files. So let's just run these tools. Yeah, so we have list of most impacted files. We see that this file impact on these files because it's included in this header. So these files impact on this number of files because it's included in these files and extra, extra. And also we have unincluded headers. And let's check if it's really unincluded headers. Just grab. Yeah, we see that this file used in only in build files. This file is not included in source file. So sometimes it's very easy when you have big project and you have refactoring and you forget delete some headers that you don't use anymore.
Sorry, and it is actually included in resource file. So probably you have to specify resource file extensions as well.
Yeah. Yeah, of course you can add these extensions, but no, I mean in CPP files. No, okay, let's check this file. One moment. Yeah. So yes, for example, these files, yeah, is included in only in index and don't use in sources files. And let's see all unincluded files. We set report limit 0, it means show all files, and we found that all files that are included. Now, of course, maybe we use it in some specific case that we didn't file, but almost it's pretty useful. And also, we have feature that show includes that is included in different way. For example, and we should disable ignore system includes. So we see that these files is included in this way. And also this files is included in this way. So it's convenient to follow your code style in the project of if you include system files only with this, you can find it when you make top or mistake. So let's come back to presentation. Yeah. These tools support JSON compilation database that is generated by CMake, and it can be more convenient read the file because it stores information about included paths. Let's see example. Okay. Let's clone projects that use CMake, and which project uses CMake, of course, CMake. Yeah, let's finish. So opens project directory, make build directory for CMake. Yeah, and write CMake with export compile commands. Need just add this flag. Yet finish, and now check what was generated. Yeah, we see that CMake generated CMake file when we see work directory for compile, command for compiles, just run C++ compiler with some parameters and also with included path. And these tools can parse these parameters and we see source file for our compiles. Let's close and let's run CPPINCLUDE. Yeah, we've seen that it's finished. And yeah, of course, some files is unresolved, but it's system files or files from some users. For example, these headers use it on Windows platform. And you can set path to this generated file, just use comment argument or in configuration file. So let's see. We exit from current directory and run these tools and set path to the generated file. Let's check. Yeah, we have the same result. So that's all. Do you have any questions?
This tool seems pretty useful. However, I just tried in my huge project and it complained something about Unicode characters.
Oh, maybe. About Unicode, I didn't check. Do you mean you have Unicode in file name?
I'm not sure. Maybe some source file has Unicode symbols that can't be parsed by the tool.
Maybe. No, I didn't check Unicode, but usually it's strange to have Unicode in source. So if you don't have question, thanks for your time and have a nice day.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good day.
Bye.
Thank you.